Very good morning, students. Welcome back to second year physics. So let us the new chapter started, that is moving charge and magnetism. In the previous class, we finished about a ampere right hand thumb rule. Let I want to say about a Fleming's left hand rule. Sir, what will be the Fleming's left hand rule? Of course, Fleming's left hand rule. It is FLR. We can also call FLR. Sir, what will be the use of Fleming's left hand rule? I'll tell you first rule, or I mean to say, I'll tell you use. By using a Fleming's left hand rule, we can find. See, we can find a force acting. Force acting on the charge moving through the magnetic field. We can get by using a Fleming's left hand rule. That means here, when charge is moving through the magnetic field, then there will be a force is to be act. That force we can get. This is the one use. And come to the second use. In the magnetic field, in a given magnetic field, if a conductor is carrying a current carrying conductor which is placed in the field, there also we can get the force acting on the current carrying a conductor. These are the two uses which are very, very important. By using a Fleming's left hand rule, we can get both charges moving through the magnetic field. We can calculate the force acting on the charge, and the current carrying conductor is placed in the field. On the current carrying a conductor, how much force is acting, we can get by using the Fleming's. Sir, what is Fleming's left hand rule? Of course, let us stretch a left hand like this. So that left hand is stretched like this, there will be a three fingers which are like this. Three are mutually perpendicular. In this left hand, you see, one is the thumb, one more is the forefinger, and one more is the center finger. Sir, what it is indicates? What it is indicates? Yes, you draw that diagram. There will be a forefinger, and there will be a central finger, and there will be a two or the folded fingers. You can say like this. And here another one is, we can say like this. Clear? So that these three can be indicated. What it is indicated? Here, look at this forefinger indicates the direction of a magnetic field, and here this central finger indicates the direction of moving charge, or we can also say velocity of the charge. V we can say, or we can also say current direction, because charge moving is nothing but there will be a current is produces in a given a field, and due to the charge moving in a given a field, there will be a force is to be created. The force will act along the direction of a thumb, so that that force we can get by using the charge moving. See, in a magnetic field, this finger indicates which one. This is the forefinger, we can say. Forefinger indicates the direction of a magnetic field, and the central finger indicates the direction of a charge or current or velocity. Because of the charge moving, there will be a force is generated. The force which is along the direction of a thumb is to be act like this. This is about a Fleming's left hand rule, FLR we can say, FLR. Now by using this, so this is, we can say, significance of a Fleming's left hand rule. That is the first significance we can get. The by using this, determine the direction of a force acting on the current carrying a conductor kept in the uniform magnetic field. It is used to determine the direction of a force acting on the charge moving in the uniform magnetic field. Yes, these are the very, very important. By using this, we can get. Now let us come to the pointers. There will be a very, very important another one is, we can say, on the basis of Fleming left hand rule, now we need to find a force acting on the charge moving. The side reading as it is for 4 marks question. Of course, force acting on the charge moving through the magnetic field, right? When there is a charge is moving in a given a magnetic field, so that by using the FLR, now we are using the FLR, now we need to find a force. See, in a given a field, suppose there is a field is given like this B. In this field, there is a charge is moving. So that charge is Q, or we can say velocity or current direction I.
So it is stretched like this, no?
Yes, of course. So that it is making an angle theta like this. And when there is a charge is moving, therefore there will be a force is created. That force direction indicated by the thumb. Yes, of course, you stretch like this. It's not exactly perpendicular, right? It is making some angle theta with the direction of magnetic field. It is the direction of magnetic field, right? And here, this force is actually depends. This force is created by the charge moving only. That mean here, it is moving with a speed v, no? If there is no charge, is there any force? No. If there is no magnetic field, is there any force? No. That mean here, this force is purely depend on magnetic field and the charge. Not only that, the moving speed. Therefore, the v can be resolved into two components. One we can say v cos theta, and one more we can say v sin theta. Nothing but what? The force is depends on the magnetic force which is created by the charge moving with a speed is v and in a given a field. Therefore, the force is acting, or the force is directly proportional to b. Force is also directly proportional to q, and force also directly proportional to velocity. The velocity, in that velocity, one of the component only. Sir, which one we can take? Of course, we can take a v sin theta. I'll tell you why v sin theta. Why not v cos theta? I'll tell you. Therefore, this all forces, this left side you look at, all are the forces. Right side it is different. F directly proportional to q, v, b sin theta. Shall I write like this? Now, let us introduce some constant is k, q, v, b sin theta. That constant you take as a 1, then f is equal to, we can say, q, v, b sin theta. So this is the force acting on the charge moving. Just now I told you, no, that is when charge is moving through the conductor, there will be a what happens, that must be what happens, there is a charge is create the force. Therefore, we can take like this. And here, not only that, we can also write like this, F is equal to Q into V cross B. We know about a cross product, no, because the V is the velocity, is a vector, and B is the magnetic field vector, so that the cross product of any two vector is V cross B is equal to VB sin theta. Again, we'll get the same. Look at, you won't write V cross B, it is, then it is gives the VB sin theta only. Of course, we can take it like this. Now, come to the point is, sir, why it is V sin theta, why not it is V cos theta? Yes, of course, I'll tell you. In this cases, you go for the first case, if you say, it is the direction of magnetic field and there will be a charge is moving with a speed is v parallel to the b. Parallel to the b is nothing but angle is how much? Zero. If there is an angle is how much? The charge is moving through the magnetic field at an angle theta is equal to zero. That means b and v are in the same direction. Or we can also say if they are in anti-parallel also no problem. That is b is and v is theta is equal to 180. If I take like this, what will happen? So that the force acting on the current carrying a charge or the charge through the charge, that is we can say q v b sin 0. Therefore, force is how much? No, there is no force created. Is there any force created? No. When it is other than 0 degree and when it is other than 180 degree, look at, you take a theta is equal to 180 also, what happens? F is equal to q v b sin 180, right? What will happen? Sin 180 also 0. So that when it is parallel or anti-parallel, there is no force acting on the charge. Charge moving through the field. If it is parallel or anti-parallel, there is no force. That's what here we are not taking the v cos theta, because which is parallel to the b, no? If it is parallel to the b, is there any force is acting? No. That's the reason we are not considering the v cos theta. We are only taking the v sin theta. When it is to be parallel, no? Of course, there is a parallel vectors principle is there. I told you in the first year also. Suppose that for late it is, we can take, there will be a b is equal to bx I cap, by j cap, or you remember, bz k cap, because it is a vector. Of course, velocity vx I cap, vy j cap, and vz k cap, these are parallel, no? For parallel vectors, there is a one formula is there, that is we can say bx by vx, ii is to be divide, and jj is to be divide, See, this is BZ by K, VZ is equal to constant. When they are parallel, if they are parallel, yes, of course, we can take it like this. So, when it is theta is parallel, theta is 0 or anti-parallel theta is 180, there will be no force acting on the charge moving through the uniform magnetic field. Now, come to the point is, if suppose I want to say, if perpendicular, sir, what will happen if perpendicular? Yes. We'll see perpendicular, what will happen and what will be the answer. See, perpendicular, theta is 90, therefore F is equal to QVB sine 90. Of course, it is 1 QVB is the maximum we can call if it is moving perpendicular. Therefore, there will be a maximum force is act, maximum force is act on the charge moving. When it is perpendicular, if it is parallel, if it is anti-parallel, there is no force. Nothing but a what? You say 0 and 180, you leave the two angles. Because 0 is nothing but a, there is no force. And 180 also there is no force. If theta 90, of course it is maximum. So apart from these three angles, we can take other angles also. Because 0 and 180 is 0. If 90 is the maximum, no? Yes. This is about a force acting on the charge moving through the uniform magnetic field. There will be a force is to be acting maximum, it is theta is 90. If theta is, we can say like this, when it is to be 0 and 180, we cannot say force acting on the charge. Clear? Now, let us come to the point. Now, we'll go for the other explanation related to the same issue. If there is a charge, it is entering into the uniform magnetic field. Charge is entering into the uniform magnetic field. The field is given as, see, there is a cross field. I told you very clear in the last class. See, cross in the sense is the direction of current is, it is into the plane of a paper. This is a very, very important, I am telling you. See, when the direction of current is, that is mean your cross if it is given, so we can say what it is, the direction of current will be into the plane of a paper. That is what it is, we can say magnetic field direction, and as well as the all we should know, when it is the direction of current is, we can say into the plane of a paper, right? And the direction of current as well as the magnetic field also inward into the plane, we can say like this, into the plane. The direction of field is into the plane. It is indicates the curling fingers. And I want to tell you one more. Into the field is nothing but a B is we can take as the minus K cap. Out of the plane is we can take as the plus K cap. This is we can say into the plane. It is out of the plane. So this R also very, very important. When it is minus K cap is indicates a, it is nothing but into the plane of a paper. Plus K cap is indicates a out of the plane of a paper. The direction of magnetic fields. Now in a given a field, if there is a charge is entering, so that there is a charge is entering into the plane or in a given a magnetic field, the field is, it is into the plane of a paper. Therefore, the charge is entering at a perpendicular. Sir, if parallel we know, parallel is nothing but a, there is no force created. If it is enters into a perpendicular to the uniform magnetic field, therefore there it is what happens, sir. Yes, of course the charge is entering into the uniform magnetic field. Therefore, the path of the particle will be circular one, like it is rotates in a circular path. So when it is rotating is nothing but what happens, there will be a magnetic force is acting towards the center as the centripetal force. Right? There is a FM is acting towards the center. When it is entering into the uniform magnetic field at an angle theta 90, perpendicular enters, therefore the path of the charged particle will be circular one. Circle. And here on this circle, if you draw a tangent, the tangent is represented as the speed of the charged particle. Yes, of course. And here the magnetic force is acting, which is towards the center of the magnetic field, center of the given circle. Of course, this magnetic force and centripetal forces are balances. That is the issue is different. And come to the point is, I want to say, work done is what happens, Fs cos theta. Work done on the charge is entering perpendicular. Work done is equal to Fs cos theta. Theta is 90, then work done is equal to Fs cos 90. Therefore, it is 0. Work done is 0. But whereas the speed is changes, speed is, because it is tangent is represented, no, speed is changes, but it is, momentum is constant, very, very important it is. Not only that, kinetic energy also constant it is. These are the which are very, very important. So when charge is entering into the uniform magnetic field at a perpendicular, therefore the charged particle path will be circular one. And your work done on the charged particle will be Fs cos theta, because it is entering 90 degree, no, you say 90. Cos 90 is 0, therefore work done on the charged particle is 0. And whereas the speed is changes, because the tangent is represented, no, at a different points, the speed will be different. And there will be a magnetic force which is acting towards the center like this. Is it okay? Now based on this, there is a centripetal and centrifugal forces are balances, no? Then you say, you know, magnetic force is nothing but a QVB equation 1, and here centripetal force is nothing but a MV square by R. You take a equation 2. And here come to the point is, I want to say, if the charged particles are, which charged particle is entering? The charged particles, I'll tell you the masses of the charged particles. Let us, I want to say about a proton. See, proton is nothing but a positive charge. There will be a mass of the proton is, we can say M, and charges we can say, here it is Q. And like you take a second particle, I want to say deuteron. If deuteron mass is also, it is, we can say deuteron in the sense is 1H2, right? It is, proton is nothing but a 1H1. And the charge will be same. And come to the point is, I want to say alpha particle. That is, alpha is nothing but He24. Of course, the mass will be, we can say 4M. And charge will be like this. I think everyone know about these issues. And mass of a proton in general, I want to say in general mass of a proton, that is the proton mass is 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 kg. And charge of proton we can say Q, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. We should remember this all. Like here we know this mass of proton and like electron mass is, we know mass of electron will be 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg it is. Like charge of electron will be 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. One is plus, one more is negative. So at least we should remember these the masses. But we can also take a mass is M, deuteron mass is 2M. That mass will be 1.6 into 10 power minus 27. And if I want to say deuteron mass 2M, 2M in the sense M, we can say 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 also we can. Like charges are same, because 1H2 is the deuteron, 1H1 is the proton. He24 is nothing but a helium particle, or we can also call alpha particle. Now let us, I want to say, if the charged particle is entering into the uniform magnetic field, there will be a force. Is the maximum is acting, that force will be what? It is F is equal to QVB, and there will be a centripetal force is acting, what it is, we can say MV square by R. Suppose you equal this to, then we may get QVB is equal to, it is MV square by R. So here it is, we cancel velocity, QB is equal to MV by R. Therefore, radius of the circular path will be like this. It is, we can call the radius. Radius of the circular path will be, we can say R. Radius of the circular path will be R is equal to MV by QB. Suppose I want to say velocity of the charged particle. You say velocity is nothing but a V is equal to, from here, that you say QB R by M. This is the velocity. Suppose I want to say in a momentum, then momentum is nothing but a MV, no? Then here you write R is equal to P by, it is QB. Then QP is equal to, it is, we can say like this, momentum. In terms of momentum, we can say. Like here also we can say, in case of a this thing, for which we can say kinetic energy. Suppose I want to say kinetic energy is equal to half MV square. So what is V now? V is, you write here, K is equal to 1 by 2 M into Q square, B square, R square by M square. So you cancel 1M. K is equal to Q square, B square, R square by 2M. This is about a kinetic energy. This is about a kinetic energy. Like here we have again, like a angular momentum, angular velocity, like time period, frequency we need to get. So here I want to say about a angular velocity. Angular velocity, that is about a omega, right? But we know here V is equal to R omega. So you take anyone, either R you want to substitute here, or you want to substitute V also, no problem. So I'll go with V. So Q B R by M is equal to R omega. Then angular velocity is equal to Q B by M. Of course it is. Like time period, because the particle is which is revolving in the circular orbit, no, there will be a time period. The oscillation of a particle, we can say time period. Time period of the particle, capital T is equal to 2 pi by omega. Then T is equal to 2 pi by omega. What will be the omega? QB by M. So T is equal to 2 pi M by QB it is. So this is time period. Like I want to say about a frequency. Sir, what will be the frequency? Yes. You say frequencies. That is the neta is equal to 1 by time period. Therefore, frequency is equal to 2 pi by m by qb. Therefore, right here, n is equal to qb by 2 pi m. This is about a frequency. We can also call f. So like this, these are the parameters which related to the when the particle is entering perpendicular. Therefore, these all the parameters are depends. It is when the charged particle is entering perpendicular to the uniform magnetic field, right? So you read this all the formulas we should remember, because further classes it is required, right? This is about a today's class, and here we'll see in the next class. In the next class, continuation we have on the basis of this. Of course, we have some problems also based on this, right? Okay, so I'll tell you some on this basis also. I want to see the problems. Right. Yeah, there is one question, page number 204. On the basis of this, 204, page number. Page number 204. There is a question number is example problems. Page number 204, question number is 3. See, what is the radius of the path of an electron? Mass of the electron given, Me is equal to 9 into 10 power minus 31 kg. And charge of electron is given, the question only given, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, moving at a speed 3 into 10 power 7 meter per second. In a magnetic field induction is given, it is 6 into 10 power minus 4 tesla, perpendicular to the field 90 degree. What is the frequency? Of course, is asking frequency. Calculate the energy also, that is kinetic energy, in kV, that is kilo electron volt. Here the mass is given, charge of electron given, velocity given, B given, entering perpendicular. So first one, frequency. Just now we did the frequency, you know, that is n is equal to, we know the formula of frequency. Yes, you can refer the charge formula for the frequency. That is, we can say it is bq by 2 pi m, right? Because time period is 2 pi by m into bq, no? Then you take directly this. So we know frequency n is equal to b is the given as 6 into 10 power minus 4 into q, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 and 2 pi, 2 into 3.14 into mass of the electron 9 into 10 power minus 31. Of course, I told you so many times, first you minimize the 10 powers. So 2 ones, 2 threes, 3 ones, 3 threes is cancelled. and here n is equal to 10^23, 1.6 into 3.14 into 3 into 10^-23 into 10^31, right? So of course here we can take like this, frequency is equal to 1.6 divided by 12, 1, 3, 4 and 3, 3 is 9 into 10^-23, and here 31 is there, no? So subtract this, we may get the 2, right? So from this it is subtracted, no? Maybe it is 12, plus 12 we'll get. So now you divide this, we may get the final answer. It is for frequency. I'll tell you the frequency. What will be the frequency? Here it is, 1.6 divided by 9.42. See, approximately n is equal to 0.16 into 10^12 hertz. Right? 1.6 divided by 2 ones, 2 threes, 3 threes, okay, 3.14 into 3, 9.42. So 1.6 b is 6 into, of course, that is 1.6. So that your 6 into 1.6, 9.6. So divided by 9, if I take 1.06, so there may be answer is wrong. We are getting why 31 10^7, here we did wrong. Field, this is answer, right? And is also asking kinetic energy in kilowatt, megahertz, half mv square or half m into v. We know that is, you write directly, we can say it is a q square b square r square by m square, no? So that we'll get q square b square r square by 2m, but we need a r, because r is not given, no? Then r you get, r is equal to mv by qb. Everything is there. If you substitute this, we may get the 26 centimeter. So that, yeah, there you write, we'll get the final answer. Okay, you do that and approximately we'll get the 2.5 kilo electron volt. This is the kinetic energy, right? So this is the today's class, and we'll continue next continuation. Some problems are there on the basis of this, we'll do the problems. Thank you very much.